Trevor is going to be home any minute.
I don't care.
Yeah, but babe, I'm not going to be able to relax.
Who said I wanted you to relax?
Yeah, but he's going to be wondering where I am.
I thought you said that you wanted me.
I do. I really do.
Well, then kiss me.
You drive me insane.
Maybe it was the wind.
Oh, yeah, but unlock the door and then close it again. There. Somebody was in here. Somebody saw us.
Well, the camera's recording, so...
You really are a total and utter nutjob.
Hot one, though, right? There.
No, wait. Go back.
That's Esther.
You have to find her. George.
Why would she come up here?
This is where she comes to clear her head, all right? The fresh air's good for the baby.
Because you're the perfect birthing partner. You know, the pregnancy yoga, the photos of the baby bump. You know, but behind her back, you're at it with Kim.
I care about Esther.
Yeah, right.
Trevor, please.
Get off me.
Look, Kim is unhinged. I mean, one minute she's making threats and the next minute she's telling me how much she wanted me. The moment I had my baby, our baby, in our arms, I would have just cut her off completely.
Cut her off? What? Like what? She's addicted to you.
She's a freak.
Well, Grace Black of old would have taken her out.
Yeah, that's the problem. That was the old me. Now, this time I had a choice. A death on my hands or a bit of infidelity. Yeah, Kim's a raving stalker, but killing her? Maybe it's the mother thing, but I'm not sure I could live with that.
A complete and utter off-the-wall nightmare.
Yeah, but you love me, though. Esther! Esther!
Look, don't you walk away from me! No, I don't... I mean, is this some sort of joke? Some sort of... I don't know.
It's just me.
Wait a minute. The bridesmaid's dress, the one he stole from the shop. Oh, my son's a tranny.
No.
He said I've been stretching my tights.
You know what I caught her doing with Kim?
He knows. And we're working things out.
She cheats on you with a mad lesbian and you're okay with that?
You're stuck there in a dress!
I don't expect you to understand.
Oh, so you are gay?
No!
So you want to be a woman?
No!
You know what? I don't need to know, because you know what? He's wrong! That's what it is!
You know what's wrong? What she's doing to Esther. Using her to get a baby. Pretending to be her mate and then sleeping with her girlfriend.
Wait, what are you doing?
I knew Kim was obsessed with you. She made me promise not to tell Esther.
Just, give me the phone.
She blackmailed me, threatened to tell you about this.
Put the phone down.
Now you know the truth, there's nothing to stop me.
Dylan!
Kim's cheating on you with Grace. That should do it.
What have you done?
Give me back my phone.
What, so you can send another message?
It's my phone.
Right, until Grace finds Esther, you're staying here. Now get up there and get that stuff off.
No.
Are you trying to tip me over the edge? I've got to get back to the club, it's our opening night.
Oh, sorry, have I ruined things?
Just a bit. Now get changed.
This isn't about you. None of this is about you. I'm not doing it to make you mad. I'm not rebelling or anything.
Well, why are you doing it then?
It makes me feel better.
That's even more disgusting.
Dad.
Don't call...
What? Call you that?
Don't speak to me. You know, I wanted you to be the best man at the wedding. I would have been so proud. Thought of you standing next to me, my own son.
Well, why does this change anything?
You know, I even wanted you to take my name. You know, when the little one was born. You know, one name, one family. I was going to talk to your mum, tell her to have a word with you about it. I wanted everyone to know that I was your dad. Now get up there.
Please.
I never want to see you wearing that stuff again.
Dad! 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 Let me out! Let me out! thought I was on my own in the flat. I thought I was safe. And then I heard Kim and Grace. I was so freaked, I just ran.
And you were properly dressed up?
Dad basically disowned me. Is it that sickening? Am I that much of a freak?
No, of course not. This is all him. He's the moron. He's the one you should be angry at.
I could change who I was.
No. You are like this amazing person. Hate him, not yourself.
You're right. Give me that.
What are you doing?
This is just the start.
Ugh, please tell me you found Dylan.
Your dad's car, is it safe to drive?
Probably not.
Grace, where's Esther?
I have just sent him to a relaxing spa in the middle of nowhere.
No, I told you I was sorting it. I told you I was getting your baby.
Yeah, you say a lot of bonkers things.
You need to call her.
I've got Esther's phone, and I've managed to swipe Sinead's too.
Because there's no way of even contacting them.
That's kind of the point.
This is all your fault. You told me all that stuff about keeping us a secret until she gave birth.
Oh, what have you done?
I swiped her drink.
With what?
A drug. A drug that induces labour.
Are you insane?
Big flashy car like this. Should the engine really sound like a hairdryer?
Try it again.
I've tried. We're going nowhere. I can't find my phone. Give me yours. I mean, honestly, do not believe this. Oh,
Sinead, it's not here.
Oh, oh, great, great. So we're stranded here until someone else comes along.
Ow. Ow. But it started a while back. I told you the baby was sitting low.
Wait, how low are we talking?
I don't know.
Like labour low?
Okay, that felt different.
Okay, Esther, look at me, look at me. Please, do not do this to me now.
Do you think I need to go to hospital?
Yes, I do.
And now...
I thought my dad was going to be driving that car.
You can't do anything about it now.
I can. I can tell my dad.
He'll kick you out.
But Sinead and Esther...
Leave it. They'll be fine.